My cousin just defended her overweight son after he ate all my birthday cake before it was time to eat it. Reddit, have you ever seen a parent defend someone over something outrageous? Not defending terrible children so much as enabling them. But my ex-GF, from way back in high school, had the worst nephews I've ever seen. They both had BB guns. One time the older one, 8 I think, got mad over something. I don't remember what, maybe chores. So he shot out the side windows in his mom's car. She took his BB gun away as punishment, so he grabbed his 4-year-old brother's BB gun and shot some windows in the house. She wouldn't take that one away because it wouldn't be fair to his brother. He didn't do anything, but she did try to send him to his room. Then he said, "I'll kill you, you B," and she felt so bad for making him hate me that she just gave up on punishment and gave him ice cream. I was sitting on a bus to go into Manhattan and this lil 5YO kept tugging on my hair. I asked the mother to please get him to stop in a very polite manner. What does she do? Absolutely nothing. What do I do? I grabbed his grubby lil hand the next time he tried to reach for it and threatened to feed it to a hobo. He immediately stopped and the ride was a lot more pleasant. I'm sure that hobo is disappointed he didn't get his lunch. This one time all us cousins were playing in the backyard having fun, when one cousin, I'll call Sam, decided to grab a full-size branch and smack another cousin, I'll call Alice, in the face with it. Not only did it cut her to the point blood soaked her shirt, but she ended up having to get stitches all over her face. His mother, one of my aunts, didn't even bother getting up to see if Alice was okay, even though she was the one watching us. And when she was confronted by Alice's mother, she merely replied, "Boys will be boys." Poor Alice carries the scars to this day. My aunt and her 3 kids were usually accidentally not told about family gatherings, because she had zero control over the brats. If they ever came to visit, me and my sister would hide our favorite toys, because they'd probably break them. They were the kind of kids who'd start smashing a toy against a wall just to see if it would break. Of course it freaking will. During one of my dad's birthday celebrations, we'd set out a big buffet table with all kinds of nice food, so people could eat, drink and socialize in our garden. My cousins went over and took one or two bites out of dang near everything on the table. My mother was absolutely livid. She had to be restrained by her brother while my dad told my aunt and her kids to leave. All the while she's laughing it off, saying they are just kids and all the rest. Disgraceful. This is how my former stepbrothers were. They were white trash pieces of garbage and would destroy everything I owned if I didn't hide it. It got to the point where I very nearly dreaded Christmas, because it meant that I'd have to entertain them rather than spend time with my family. Thankfully, my mom divorced their dad during my freshman year of high school. Teen boy and his friends were racing in my neighborhood, took a turn too tight and broke off the fire hydrants in my lawn. Water was shooting 30 feet into the air. I heard the whole thing and ran out there only to chase after the kid as he backed up, ripping up my lawn in the process and tried to run off. His car died at the end of the street and one of the neighbors held him while his friends scattered. Father insisted to my face, even though I saw his son run off, and told him that he wasn't racing and didn't try to run away. He just took a turn too tight and wanted to get away from the water. All this while our neighborhood is getting flooded. My ex-sister-in-law defended her 13-year-old son after he punched a 2-year-old by saying he's got anger control issues. It's not his fault, granted. She's right that he has issues. But when the 2-year-old's mom got angry, she acted like the other mom was crazy. Dude, that is just insane. My parents have these friends who had a kid late in life, and they let that kid run freaking rampant. He curses, screams, kicks, bites, breaks crap, etc. One evening, we were all sitting out in their backyard at a BBQ, and this kid drops trow on the porch steps and starts to take crap. His mom yelled, "Bryce, goddammit, go further out for that." So the kid stops mid-crap, waddles further out into the yard with his pants around his ankles still, and finishes. When my mom tried to say something about it, the kid's mom got up in arms and said, "What the heck are you expecting from him? He's only 5. Well, at least there's some discipline. That's a good thing. He'll have good yard shit and manners. When I was in 4th grade, a mean girl would always bully people into giving her their things, playing with her at recess, etc. She was never kind, and would never take no for an answer. Both of our mothers were teachers there, so at times, I felt obligated to hang out with her, despite that she was mean to my friends and me too. One day I decided I'd had enough, and told her to take a freaking hike, the best way a fourth grader knew how. I told her we couldn't play together anymore until she felt like being nice, but until then I wanted to be left alone. Not 2 hours later, I'm being pulled out of class by her mother, another teacher and the bully bee. Her mother stood over me for the next 20 minutes, scolding me for being unkind and bullying her daughter. All the while, the little bee stood in the background snickering at me. What the frick, school? Even if they felt like disciplining you without notifying your parents, they sure as frick shouldn't have let the overreactive mother do it. Went into a shop where a little kid was running about crazy. I stand in line to ask the staff a question. The boy runs up and kicks me as hard as he can. Mother told me it is because you are a stranger. Yeah, because that absolves you're a child from being wrong, does it? He is a stranger to me. I never kicked him in the face back, did I? Oh crap, forgot to add, my niece's birthday came and her brother decided to destroy the house because he wanted presents to and it was unfair. His aunt, other side of family, said that it is okay, she will take him to get his presents, and it was our fault for not including him. The women never even bought my niece anything, not even a sweet. Comma, it is because you are a stranger. No, it's because you're a crappy parent. I was in a Walmart buying a frozen pizza for dinner a few weeks ago, and there was this kid, about 6 or 7, in front of me screaming because he wanted a candy bar. This old man in a wheelchair behind me yelled, "You're singing out of pitch. Sing it right or shut up." My greatest moment in Walmart. I like when old people use their superpowers for good. He ate the entire freaking cake. Cake is like the symbol of gluttony. Like if you tell someone you ate a whole pizza last night, they'll say, "Oh wow, you must have been really hungry." But if you tell someone you ate a whole cake, they're like, "You've got a problem, Jim Gaffigan." But what kind of freaking excuse is that? Saying that you shouldn't have left it out, now that right there is a parent in pure freaking denial about their child. Probably stems from their own guilt. Deep down inside, she can't accept her child being overweight and comes up with ridiculous excuses for it so she doesn't have to blame herself. But really, the whole freaking cake? And you shouldn't have left it out? My wife's older sister doesn't believe in disciplining her kids. I crap you not. No discipline at all. They can do whatever they want. One time we were having dinner and the 3-year-old daughter is standing on her mom's chair between her legs. She leans over the table and plants both hands into the salad bowl just as I was going for some. But she then just stays in that position with her back bent at 90 degrees. There was a long silence. My wife looked at her sister, who did nothing, and then walked outside to keep from exploding at her. I excused myself too. What a waste of a beautiful salad that was. I worked as a private investigator for a few years. I carry my gun all the time. One night my cousin comes to visit me with her 13-year-old son. More backstory: people within my family always consider me to be nice, strict, and fair. I am also ex-military. So, this little sucker gets into my room, broke the lock, loads my gun, wore the page 5, and tries to leave with it. I am a freaking detective. I can tell you are acting funny. I ask him what is wrong. My cousin knows me well. She stops and stands in front of the door. This crap stick draws on me. I draw on him. S&W.44 model 629. It's a much bigger gun. He drops the gun. His mother went ape crap. How can you point a gun at him? He wasn't going to shoot. You shouldn't have guns. She doesn't visit me anymore because I am a dangerous man that shoots the children. My uncle and his family live with my grandmother. His wife has an iPad that she lets her son use. He is 4. My grandmother also has an iPad but keeps it in her room mostly. Recently my cousin has been acting quite spoiled. The worst situation was when my uncle had friends over and my cousin went into my grandmother's room and took her iPad while she was sleeping, took it outside and damaged it quite a bit. My grandmother was obviously not very happy and she told my cousin that he was not allowed to use her iPad again. My useless aunt got pee and started shouting at my grandmother and telling her that he was just a baby and that she needed to stop picking on him. My cousin has also been known to hit her and break her things. My grandmother just takes it now. The worst part is that his parents don't correct him. one of my brothers was playing around with my friend's older brother. I think he was telling him that Rancid, the punk band, sucked or something. Instead of telling him frick you or you don't know what you're talking about, this older brother took the ottoman from the family room and threw it at my brother's head. WWF style. This kid's parents were sitting at the dinner table with my parents and instead of getting up to see if my brother was okay or if he had a concussion, they went to him and told him, "Why did you provoke him?" They tried to justify this to my parents to make them come down on my brother for provoking their disgruntled son. My dad kicked them out. I'm the father of two young kids, and I will yell at any poorly behaved child in my area. If the parents aren't going to tell their kid it's wrong to hit or throw sand, I will. I've found that if the parents get pissy at you, you don't say a thing. You just give them a disgusted look and they wilt, just like their spoiled crap children do. The parents and the kid both know they're doing wrong, but not enough people call them on it. My second cousin is a little son of a bee. He's about 7 years old and his mother, my first cousin, has no control over him because of her lack of anything. One day he's throwing his Wii games that were in the cases around my aunt's house. I tell him to stop. He throws one and it is another cousin in the face. She starts crying, so I go over to her and told the little crap to stop throwing stuff. He flings another one in my direction and when I get up to go after him, he takes off. I picked up a game case and ninja starred it right into the back of his knee. I guess I threw it hard enough at his frail 7-year-old body that it made knee buckle, which in turn made him fall and slam face first into the door jam. His mom comes running accusing us of hurting him. I told her he tripped. My cousin whom he hit backed me up. I was working retail one day and this kid of about 6-9 years old comes in with his whale of a mother. It was a pretty busy day and we had associates everywhere trying to get work done. Well, this kid comes in and starts picking up things off the shelves, looking in them briefly, and then proceeds to throw them over his shoulder and move on. I then have to approach them and ask them if they need any help finding something today. The boy just grunts and keeps moving on throwing things off the shelves. At his point I go grab my MOD and tell them to get him out of the store because it's going to be my butt that has to clean that up. When he goes and approaches the woman, she starts yelling, "This is my freaking right and his freaking right as citizens of this country to do what we please." We had to threaten to call security to get them to leave. Some people. When I was in junior high school, I was kind of a loser. I had been fat and quiet throughout my childhood, and I had maybe 2 friends, the rest of my class bullying me pretty much non-stop. Suddenly, the puberty fairy came, and I grew about 1.5 feet with pretty nice boobs and a decent butt without gaining a pound overall. This guy I knew early on kept telling everyone that I grew T because I was a S. He mocked me relentlessly for my perceived SUAL indiscretions. I tried to ignore him, but when he tried to pull up my skirt one day in the halls, I had enough. I reported him to the teacher and the guidance counselor, and he got in a minimal bit of trouble. His mom came in to have a little talk with my mom in attendance. She said it was just a case of boys being boys, so he shouldn't be punished. And anyway, from what I've heard from son's name, everyone's seen it all already anyway. Freaking believable. Sounds like Dudley Dursley. Happy birthday though. Thanks. I'd say get them a gift, but make it something like a workout video or something. Make it a Richard Simmons one too. My cousin is a cheeky bastard. He regularly spits on and hits me and my other cousins. His mom defends him, saying he has had it. He is perfectly fine, but he is just a spoiled son of a bee. God freaking damn it. Nobody told me I could use my ADHD as an excuse to treat other people like garbage. What a missed opportunity. Backup cakes are always a good idea. Eat him, see how he likes it. But he isn't cake, and probably not near as delicious. At Jake's next birthday party, you should sneak off when everyone's busy and eat his whole cake. Then when he starts crying, yell, "Revenge is AB, you fat little C." When he starts asking for his cake back, throw it up into his mouth like a mother bird feeding its baby. And if you can't eat it, soak it with vinegar. And my parents say I'm crazy for always wanting to buy a backup cake. What if something happens to Cake Prime? What if it takes a bullet for me? Man. I mean, it'd probably still be edible, but there might be a risk of lead poisoning. I've never wanted to drop kick children more than after reading this thread. My son has ADHD. He's almost 11. He is also smart, caring, funny, polite and well-mannered. He helped an older lady down the block from my mother's house carry her groceries down the block, then refused when she wanted to pay him. He holds doors for people, is gentle with littler kids and would never scream and yell or act a fool in a public place. Why? Because I raised him that way. People want to blame the disorder for terrible behavior. Number. It's lax parenting and lack of any dang home training on their parts. Yes, my son gets in trouble at school for talking too much, and I constantly have to stay on him about being lazy and doing his homework because he is so unfocused. That is a side effect of ADHD. Being in butthole is not. My friend was home one day when he saw a couple of 12-13 year old kids walking down the street hitting mailboxes with a baseball bat. He went out on his porch and yelled at them while they were still two houses down. The kids responded with a hearty frick you. He started walking towards them and they ran. About a half hour later, he gets a knock on his door from the cops asking if he threatened the two boys, and the mother of one of the kids was outside pointing and screaming at him, saying he should be arrested because it's not his right to discipline her child. My friend showed the cops the damaged mailboxes, told them he yelled at the kids to stop, and the kids' response. Cops thanked him, explained to the mother what happened, and she still was screeching for them to arrest my friend. Sounds like that fat mother sucker owes you a cake. Second cake sounds like something hobbits eat after first cake. There should be a rehab for crappy parents who never discipline their kids. They should have to be around other people's crappy kids and then be repeatedly told over and over this is the experience people get from your child. Seriously though, it's so freaking hard for some parents to think of their kids as anything but 100% innocent at all times. If she had apologized, admonished her child, would you still have kicked them out? I hate when parents don't hold their children accountable. I don't have a specific story, but I can't stand parents that defend the obesity issues of their children. Most of the time, it's a direct result of how you treat and enable your kids. My family currently has a fat little 2-year-old. They say he was a titty baby, so he's overweight. Don't breastfeed babies, when really they should be saying I fed him 3 adult size breakfast tacos and a whole can of soda and now he wants more, so I'm feeding him. You should send the kid a pair of running shoes for Christmas instead of nothing. Either that or send him a cake and then show up and eat it in front of him. Send him an empty box with a note that says it's all the leftover cake from your birthday. You have been visited by the Wealth Rat. Subscribe in 12 seconds and he will share his wealth with you. Thanks for watching. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Or don't. Either way, have a great day, you magnificent people.